प्रजापति हरि सर्व शरीरस्तु दुंते भोज्यते हरि।
As per the teachings of Ayurveda, there are six flavors that render our meals complete and whole. These are sweet, sour, pungent, astringent, bitter, and salt. In her own mystical and mysterious way, Mother Nature weaves a rich tapestry of these six flavors, such that they represent life's countless experiences. These multidimensional tastes teach us the lessons of survival, adaptation, and perpetual growth. Not only do these tastes give our bodies exceptional health, but they prepare our minds to take on the roller coaster of life with equanimity and poise. Welcome to the six divine tastes of Mother Nature.
So, Maya, when we talk of sweet tastes, one thinks of only sugar. But then what else comes under sweet?
Oh, there's plenty that comes under sweet. When we think of sugar, we are thinking of the white sugar that we get nowadays.
Or brown sugar. Processed sugar.
Yes. But in the olden days, the way Ayurveda prescribed sugar, it was actually jaggery, which is the unrefined sugar cane, made from sugarcane juice and unrefined, unprocessed. So that's what we would use as a healthy sugar.
Okay, so and that's sugar. What?
Right.
Does all these come under sugar?
Yes, and all these come under sugar.
What are they?
Things like rice that we never think of as sugar. White rice.
Okay. Is this the processed, refined white rice that is normally available today?
This is not. This one is called a hand-pound rice. And the reason it's called that is because the husk is still kept a little intact. It's kind of semi-polished, unpolished.
Okay. So there's fiber with the rice.
Yeah, there's a lot of fiber.
Okay, that's just a better alternative than white.
Much healthier.
Refined white rice.
Yes, much healthier alternative.
All right. So is there any other alternatives to white rice, refined grains like white rice and wheat? What other alternatives do we have here?
Right. So we have here what we call the wild rice, black wild rice. And this is technically not a rice. It's a seed of a grass. Grown locally here in the US, and you get it in many other countries as well.
Okay.
That's one. For wheat alternatives, we have millet flour, we have almond meal, and we have chickpea flour. These are just some of the alternatives that can be used.
So these are chickpeas and millets can be bought at home and you can simply
grind them, or you also get the organic flours ready.
Yeah, I know that you buy almonds and make these almond flour as well.
Yes, I buy the raw organic almonds and just put it into the blender and make the almond meal. So it's really nice for pancakes
and we also make almond milk at home. And what is this?
And this is cauliflower. So the vegetable cauliflower, you just put it in the processor and grind it up like this and it becomes cauliflower rice. So you just use that as a base.
Excellent. What are these now?
Okay. So these are, again, when we think of sugar, we have coconut. This is fresh coconut grated. Okay. These are dates and dried figs.
Dried figs are
also very sweet. So all these are sugars.
And I guess to sum it up, most of the fruits come under the fruit category. We just have a sample of apples, but you have bananas, mangoes,
peaches.
All of the fruits, generally, most of the fruits come under the sweet category. Yeah. So all these are where we talk of the sweet taste, which correlate to the sweet experiences of life.
Right, yes.
There are many sweet experiences in life that we gladly accept and gratefully acknowledge. For instance, the birth of a child in the family, or the joy of intimacy and companionship with our dear ones over the years, our graduation ceremony, or our wedding day, or the day we met someone who opened our eyes to life's greater possibilities. These experiences are treasured forever in our hearts and minds. May we continue to be blessed with such sweet encounters that enrich us with moments of joy and eternal gratitude.
So now we come to the sour category, right? That in Tamil we call it pulipu.
Right.
Okay. So what do we have in the sour category that we can bring into the food on an everyday basis?
So the first thing most common is lemon or lime, as
lemon.
We always have
okay.
it, right? So lemon.
So you can squeeze lemon.
Squeeze
and...
lemon into okay. your salad or in, even in
okay.
Over fruits.
Do you, even when you and cook food, do you use it as
yes,
a
we do.
Dressing or a,
we do when
okay.
we make any lentil soups like dals, as we call sometimes. In the
okay.
end, we would squeeze some lemon into
okay.
that.
Okay.
Pickles, like these are pickled olives. So
okay.
we have a variety of pickles that we get here, basically
mm-hmm.
soaked in vinegar. So vinegar mm-hmm. is the sour taste.
Okay.
And this is tamarind pulp, which we
okay.
use a lot in our Indian cooking.
Right.
We have, this is raw mango,
okay.
Kind of seasoned up with spices like red chili powder
okay.
and salt. This is a dry mango powder,
okay.
which again we use as a seasoning in many things.
Okay.
And then fermented foods as
okay.
well.
So fermented foods also come under the sour category.
Under sour category, because when you taste them, once it ferments,
okay.
it has a sour taste to it.
Right.
Idli, dosa, batter is one. And this, of course, is most common, yogurt.
Yeah. One of the greatest things about fermented food is the microbiome, the bacteria ecosystem that it helps maintain in the human system. So in the last 10-15 years, medicine has begun to understand the importance of fermented food, and eating good quality fermented food helps in maintaining a very good ecosystem. So in that context, we also have probiotics. You get some good quality probiotics that you may want to consider, right? On an everyday basis, or at least once in 3 or 4 days, you do a routine intake, so that you're building, creating a lot of variety in the bacteria eco-culture in your body. This is, what fruit is this?
That's a pomelo.
Okay.
It's again a citrus fruit. So I
okay.
guess citrus fruits are also generally on the sour side.
Correct. This could also come under sweet, a little bit. It
yeah.
has a sweetness in it.
Yeah.
So none of these are really watertight compartments.
Exactly.
At least in the, on the fruits side, it's there's always an element of
a mixture
sweetness.
Of tastes,
right,
basically.
Right. But this definitely is sour. This definitely comes under the sour category. Tamarind comes under the sour category. Okay, very interesting.
Fermentation happens when something is stored away for a period of time. There are many experiences and moments that are tucked away in the deep recesses of our mind. Experiences long since gone, but whose memories ferment, oftentimes as sourness in our thoughts and behavior. Every experience of the past has a lesson to teach. Our job is to learn these lessons and drop off the experiences. Carrying painful experiences in our memories only hurt us and stop us from living life to the fullest. We are embodiments of never-ending joy, Ananda Swarupas. Let not the over-fermented memories of the past hold us back from experiencing that inner joy. Past is past, and the future is uncertain, so be in the present, says Sai Baba. And he adds, it is not ordinary present, it is omnipresent.
So now we come to pungent taste.
Yes.
So what exactly is pungent taste? Is it a combination of spice or?
Yeah, it's a very strong flavor and it has...
Okay.
A little, yes, it does have a kind of leaves a spicy taste in your mouth. Like
okay. So what are the examples here?
Okay. So we have, when we talk about spices, we have turmeric and then we have ground cumin powder.
Cumin powder.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And this is red chili powder, dried
okay.
red chili powder.
Okay.
We have fresh chilies, green chilies here.
Green chilies, this can be eaten raw along with the
eaten
salads.
Raw, yes,
okay.
you could just chop it up, you can cook
okay.
it, you can eat it raw. Garlic, of course,
yes.
Very pungent.
Mm-hmm.
And not so good raw, but
yeah.
better cooked.
Better cooked, yes.
And onions, again, they have a little spice in them as well, right? Strong tasting.
Right.
And a lot of our herbs, they may not be very spicy, but they have strong flavors.
So what is that
so
one?
This one is cilantro. We have mint, parsley, and curry leaves. All these come under this category too.
Excellent. Now, turmeric can come also under the bitter category, correct?
Turmeric can be bitter too.
Okay. Yes, so we'll make sure we remember to include that as well. So all of this comes under the pungent taste, forms an important spice ingredient in the cooking.
Yes. Yeah, it's very good for digestion. So.
Okay. Excellent.
The pungent flavor is strong, and only the strong in body and mind will welcome this taste. Life opens many avenues for us to be instruments in bringing about change. Change in ourselves for the better, and change in our society. The pungent taste awakens the powerful leader in us and brings about changes through compelling mental and spiritual awakenings. We eat pungent food with caution and respect, just as we receive powerful awakenings and changes in our lives. When done so, it renders us strong, undeterred, and confident.
So now we have astringent taste. So what categories of food come under astringent?
So astringent, we have the legumes, like the kidney beans. These are black-eyed peas. Things like this come under astringent. It's very close to the pungent taste.
And these are kidney beans?
Yes.
Okay.
These have to be cooked and had.
Right.
In fruits, we have pomegranate. Apple comes under astringent as well.
As well, yes. In addition to sweet.
In addition
That's
to sweet.
That's why we said so fruits have a mix of taste,
mix
which is very
taste,
good. Right.
Yes.
What are these?
Avocados are astringent taste. And then green beans. Carrots, cauliflowers, and we have cilantro, which again comes, like we had it in pungent, it also comes into astringent taste.
And so a lot of raw vegetables come under the astringent category.
Taste.
And incidentally, this is extremely good fat as well for the brain. It's called the brain food.
Yes.
And what is this? You
and
have milk?
Milk comes under the astringent category as well.
Okay.
So.
And it's good to have organic.
Organic.
Protein.
Whole milk.
And it's good protein as well.
Good protein.
Okay.
Yes.
So all of these come under the astringent. So astringent and pungent categories are pretty close
to each
other.
Pretty close to each other. Very strong tastes.
Okay.
So.
All right.
Almost everyone has one or more experiences in life that they would call cleansing. Like astringent food cleanses the body, life gives us many opportunities to achieve that inner cleansing, not just of the body, but the inner cleansing of the mind's preconditioned ideas and limiting belief systems. The words and teachings of a divine master, wisdom from the scriptures, life and teachings of avatars and saints call us to experience the joy of unconditional acceptance, inner cleansing, and opening the doors of our minds to the eternal journey of learning and growth.
Okay, so now we come to a category which people don't want to hear about, and that's bitter.
Bitter, yeah.
Okay, what do we have in the bitter category?
Okay, so all our leafy greens are considered bitter.
Right, spinach, kale,
arugula, lettuces, arugula, even vegetables like broccoli and things like
that.
And then
I just love them raw. I must have been a rabbit. I see you have a fruit also here.
That's the pomelo, which we had it in the sour category. It also comes into bitter. It does have that little bitter taste. So I think most of the citrus Could go there.
Some of them, and grapefruit is one example.
Grapefruit,
there is leaves a bitter taste, a little bit of bitter taste in your mouth. Okay, and I see you have lemon as well.
Lemon again comes into sour and bitter.
Okay,
it goes both ways. So the rind especially.
Yeah, it makes sense because when you squeeze the lemon too much, it does leave a bitter taste.
A bitter taste. Yes.
All right, and what are these?
These are some of our spices. So this one is again cumin powder, roasted cumin powder.
Okay.
We had it in the pungent.
Okay.
It does have a slight bittery taste.
Okay.
This is fenugreek seeds.
Okay.
Okay. Very healthy, used a lot in Indian cooking. And
okay.
Turmeric, of course,
okay.
again has a bitter taste.
Okay.
This one is cacao nibs.
Cacao.
Yes.
We discovered cacao in Trinidad. It's
yes.
a country that gives really good quality
Grows
cacao.
Yeah.
Cacao is where dark chocolate comes from, right?
Yes.
Dark chocolate sounds good, but this has no sugar. This is 100% bitter cacao. It's really, really bitter.
Absolutely.
Okay. And finally.
And coffee.
Yes.
Of course, we all know it's bitter, right?
Right.
Unless you add the sugar into it. So this is just regular organic
yeah.
coffee powder.
You know, it's always good to have organic coffee powder.
Always.
Again, India, Brazil. All these places are known for good coffee.
Growing their coffee, yes.
Right. So that's bitter.
Bitter.
Okay.
Some of life's greatest challenges are presented to us in the form of bitter experiences. Everyone, without exception, goes through bitter experiences time and again. How does one endure a life-threatening illness? How does one go through the pain of losing a near and dear one? How does one plow through the hard times when one suddenly loses everything one worked for? Just like eating bitter food, the answers to these questions are neither simple nor easy. The only way out is to build mental fortitude, spiritual strength, a sense of unconditional surrender, and indomitable faith in divine orchestration.
And then finally we come to salt. I think it's pretty easy to understand what salt is. There isn't any specific salty food as such, correct?
No, other than processed foods, which
yeah, I guess some kind of sea algae and those kind of things.
Some of those.
We haven't eaten them, so we
don't know
much about them. But they can come under the salty variety. But what is it that we have here?
So this one is the pink Himalayan salt.
Pink Himalayan salt,
right.
Not the iodized kind of processed salt that you
no.
get. We don't want that.
We don't.
Okay.
This is like rock salt. Pink
rock
Himalayan
salt.
Salt.
Okay. So it's just natural.
And this is,
okay.
And this one is called black salt. It's not black in color, but we use this a lot in some of the Indian cooking because it again has a lot of antioxidants and good minerals.
Black salt is something you can sprinkle on fruit salads and things like that just to bring some taste.
Yes.
Okay.
And if you know chaat masala like we have it in India, that one of the key ingredients is the black salt.
Okay. So that salt, I think, is pretty straightforward.
Salt excites us. Helps us discover our passion. It helps us to see life as an adventure. There is always a part of us, a child in us, that constantly wishes to explore life, explore the many wonderful things that life has to offer. The idea of trekking in the mountains excites some, while skydiving may be on someone else's bucket list. Deep sea diving is yet another adventurous exploration, as is scaling high mountains. Just like salt, these life experiences enrich our personalities. The greatest adventure, however, is the inner exploration and the journeys into the multidimensional spirit that lies within. And thus we have the six heavenly flavors that not only nourish our bodies, but also empower our minds and enrich our spirits. May the divine energy of Sai bless our senses, our bodies, our minds, and our spirit.
Bhadram Karne Vishrunuyama Deva भद्रं पश्ये माक्षभिर्यजत्राः स्थिरैरङ्गैस्तुष्टुवागुंसस्तनूभिः क्षेम देवहितैर्यदायुः स्वस्ति न इन्द्रो वृत्रश्रवाः स्वस्ति न पूषा विश्ववेदाः स्वस्ति नस्तार्क्ष्यो हरिष्टनेमिः स्वस्ति नो बृहस्पतिर्दधातु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्ति।